I was 9 years old, and from what I had gathered from the zeitgeist, from family members, my community, I knew that this moment was going to be a seminal moment for us.
There are those who are asking the devotees of civil rights, when will you be satisfied? We can never be satisfied as long as the Negro is the victim of the unspeakable horrors of police brutality. We can never be satisfied. As long as our bodies...
We all saw that there was no fear. We saw his value system, his point of view about us all as human creatures. Once we saw that in him, our instincts moved us closer.
No, we are not satisfied, and we will not be satisfied until justice rolls down like waters and righteousness like a mighty stream.
As he got to the end of his speech, Mahalia Jackson kept saying, "Tell him about the dream, Martin. Tell him about the dream."
I'm standing about 50 feet behind Dr. King. Okay? And I watched his demeanor change. And I turned to the person next to me and I said, "These people don't know it, but they're about ready to go to church."
So even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream.
All the speeches that he ever made came together in that one moment, and the best of every speech was to be now revealed in the context of this great historical moment.
I have a dream. My four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. Let freedom ring from every mountainside. Let freedom ring. And if America is to be a great nation, this must become true. Let freedom ring from Stone Mountain of Georgia. Let freedom ring from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee. Let freedom ring from every hill and molehill of Mississippi, from every mountainside. Let freedom ring, and when this happens, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual, "Free at last, free at last, thanks God Almighty, we are free at last."
Being there is one of the highlights of my life. I felt clear about being an American and being a black American. What Dr. King was saying was really so simple.
Everything that has happened to me, my ability to be liberated, completely free, determining my own destiny, owning myself, happened because of that moment.
The Kennedys were worried the very moment the march appeared as a realistic possibility. But after the big event, the leaders of the march go to the White House. This is a coming together of the black civil rights movement and the Kennedy administration.
President Kennedy stood in the door of the Oval Office, and he greeted each one of us. He shook our hands one by one. He said, "You did a good job. You did a good job."
I wish I knew how it would feel. 10 hours after it began, the event that will change American politics forever was over. As the crowds made their way back, the reverberations of that day will be felt all over the world.
Say I'm loud, say I'm clear, for the whole round world to hear.
One of the things that King's Dream makes clear is that once we start dreaming of a better world and start making that better world, things that we thought were impossible become possible. And that is an inspiration.
Elected to any public office, was not standing more than 30 feet tall between President Jefferson and President Lincoln. And sometime in a flying out of Washington, I look down and see the monument of Martin Luther King Jr. It says something about the man. It says something about this country, the distance we've come, and the progress we've made.